Now at 11, a parent questions her child's school bus. She wants to know why the district is separating boys and girls on different buses.
The Osceola County mom took to Facebook today with her concerns. News 6's Jennifer Ortega went to find out the practice one parent sees as a problem.
The mother says she drove her 9-year-old daughter to the bus stop for the first day of school. And then moments later, she came running back saying they wouldn't allow her on the bus.
She's coming back and saying, Mom, the bus is only for the boys. What do you mean the bus is only for the boys?
Catherine Borrero says at first she thought it was a misunderstanding. So she went to ask the bus driver what was going on.
He said, well, we are separating the boys and the girls. Another bus is coming for the girls. And I asked him, what is this? And he said, oh, this is a new policy. New policy? I haven't got no information.
Borrero says they had to wait another 15 to 20 minutes for the girls' bus to arrive to take them to Reedy Creek Elementary School. She tells us she never received any notice from Osceola County Public Schools, and now she has to explain to her fourth grader why she can't ride the bus with her friends.
She's so young, she's seeing this separation. She don't understand why his friend that has been riding with her for the past 3 years now is riding in a different bus.
Upset by what happened, Borrero posted it on Facebook. Other parents in the comments speaking out about their concerns.
I want to know why they're separating kids by sex.
We asked the Osceola County School District for their comment, and they sent us this statement saying in part, we don't have a policy, but rather a practice. If the students at the stops exceeds the capacity of the bus, we divide them by male and female, then alphabetically. It's quicker, and this practice has been done for well over 10 years. Tonight, this mother says she wants changes.
This is the first time in 7 years. Why? Why are you doing this now and don't solve the problem in another way?
In Osceola County, Jennifer Ortega, News 6.
And News 6 contacted other school districts in Central Florida to see if they have similar practices. We posted their responses on clickorlando.com under top stories.